Hey, what's up guys? It's Abby Andrew and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be attempting to make an Elsa cosplay. It's also going to be a bit of a store-bought versus homemade cosplay comparison as well, because I'm still relatively new to cosplay crafting, so while I really want to be able to make the Elsa cosplay from scratch and be able to make it myself, I don't have 100% faith in my ability to make the cosplay, so as a backup, I ended up buying not one, but two different Elsa cosplays as backups in case the one that I'm making doesn't come out well. The wig that I'm going to be working with is the wig Lennox from Anea Paris. And it's in the color pastel pink. It's so beautiful. I'll show you it really quickly right now. Here's just like a little sneak preview. That's all you're gonna see for now because I'm definitely gonna be doing a separate video. This video, however, is going to be about the costume preparation and how to actually make the costume itself. It's also so funny because when I was deciding whether to make the cosplay myself or to buy the cosplay, I was looking at the prices of all the different cosplays and I kept seeing like the Elsa dress pre-made cost like anywhere from $30 for a low quality one to over $100 for a super, super high quality one. So in my head I was thinking like, oh, that's so expensive, I could easily make one myself for cheaper. And then by the time I had all the materials to make the cosplay myself in my Amazon shopping cart, it ended up being over $100 just for the supplies. So that's cool. And then on top of that, I was concerned about spending too much money. And then on top of that, I still went and bought the two Elsa cosplays as well. So I don't know. Honestly, if the one that I make comes out well, I'm probably going to just return the other two pre-made Elsa cosplays or maybe sell them, but I will still try them on for this cosplay comparison video so you guys can see what else is out there if you want to attempt to make your own cosplay or if you want to buy one of the two that I am going to show you. So the two that I bought, this one in this package, this came out to $38.99, and then I also bought one that's actually like, I think from Party City. Is this one here. This one was $60, so yeah, but even just between these two cosplays, I spent like $80 or something, but I'm probably going to end up returning both of these. Again, I just bought them as backups in case the one that I make doesn't come out well. But this one's cool because this one's actually from Frozen 2. It's the costume she wore in the second movie, whereas the other one is the costume she wore primarily in the first movie. So I will show those two store-bought dresses at the end. At the very end, I'm going to do a reveal of how my dress came out compared to the store-bought ones and see which one came out the best, and then which one is best for your money. So now I'm going to show you all the materials I bought to make the Elsa cosplay, and then we'll get into actually attempting to make it. So normally, if I was going to try to make an Elsa cosplay completely from scratch, I would have just bought a bunch of sparkly blue fabric and used that as the dress base and kind of just had that be the main product that I use, like the only real supply that I really needed. However, the sewing machine that I have, I've talked about it in other videos before, it's a very small, compact sewing machine. It's really cute and easy to use. However, it's very limiting because it only allows you to do a straight stitch. And for those of you that aren't familiar with sewing, in order to make any garment that has a stretch to it, you need to be able to use a zigzag stitch, which is a type of stitch that other sewing machines have. And because I don't have a zigzag stitch, I was limited to what types of garments I could make. For example, if I wanted to make Elsa's long sleeve shirt, I wouldn't have been able to make that completely from scratch because if I can't make a stretchy garment, then there's no way I'd be able to like get that on my arm because it has to be able to have some stretch to it for it to fit properly. So my solution for that was just to kind of make this cosplay using pre-made garments and then transforming those garments into an Elsa cosplay. So here is what I plan on doing. So I bought this corset from Amazon. This is what it looks like. This costs $17.99. It buttons up in the front with these little clasps. And then on the back, it's lace up. So what I plan on doing is actually stitching the front part sewn completely shut, so that it's just one solid piece in the front, leaving the back open so I can still tie it, and that's how I'm gonna be able to put it on. And then to make it into an Elsa piece, I bought this blue sparkly fabric, also from Amazon, to cover the corset. If you look at the picture of her in the movie, the glitter on her shirt is kind of more like these chunky squares, and I actually saw a fabric that was like that, but I just felt like that wouldn't have looked good in person in like real life. I just felt like this looked a little bit better for what I was going for. So for 1 yard of this fabric, it was $8.97 from Amazon. I'm gonna link all of the materials that I used below. You can feel free to use whatever other materials you want. I also bought this blue skirt. This is definitely going to be a costumey looking skirt piece, but I think that's fine because I am literally making a costume, so I don't really mind that it's like kind of costumey looking material. It doesn't feel bad, it feels kind of silky, but it definitely looks like a bit costumey the way it's like shiny like that. This skirt was only $13.99. I also bought this blue mesh leotard that I'm going to be wearing under the corset because on Elsa's costume she has these long light blue, ice blue sleeves. Hers is over her shoulders like this. This looks like it's cut like a scoop neck, so I might have to cut the edges to make it more of an over the shoulder top. That shirt cost $18.99. So again, if I was to make that shirt from fabric, which I think that would actually be super easy to do if I had the right sewing machine, I would definitely recommend you try that out. So if you look at Elsa's costume, you'll see she also has a long cape that she wears, and it's a cape that doesn't attach like around her neck like a typical cape. It kind of attaches like underneath her shoulders, like down here. So I was gonna buy some sheer blue fabric to make the cape, but the fabric for 1 yard was a little bit on the pricier end for the fabric that I was looking at. But then I stumbled upon these like wedding table runners on Amazon that were like exactly the amount of fabric I need, the exact right cut. If anything, you're getting more fabric with these, and it was so much significantly cheaper than just buying fabric. So technically these are actually table runners. It's so long. I'm pretty sure this is like 10 feet or something. Let me check the listing. But the table runner was only $15.99. It's a 10-foot long table runner, so I'm guaranteed to have the right height for my body. Whereas a yard would have been like 3 feet by 3 feet, I think, of fabric, and then I would have had to buy two and then cut it to the right size, and I probably would have wasted a lot of fabric. So this is already kind of like the perfect cut to make a cape out of. And I also wanted the cape to be removable, so I'm going to actually pin that fabric to ribbon and then add buttons to it. So I bought some ribbon to attach the cape to. This is some really cheap basic blue ribbon. This cost $5.60. The buttons I'm gonna be using I already had, but I also bought them from Amazon. It's this set of, this huge case of snap buttons. So if you buy this, you're gonna be set for buttons for life, unless you like make a lot of garments with buttons. They're kind of like studs that you push into place using this thing. But I also bought some crafting glue. This is really great crafting glue, E6000. It's really, really great for like gemstones and jewelry and stuff. This little rhinestone kit is really cool though. It's this little kit with a bunch of different sizes of rhinestones. I think it has 2,000 rhinestones in it. And this was $8.59. It also came with a couple of tools to apply the rhinestones. And lastly, I also bought these like little glue tips to put on that E6000 glue bottle. First, I'm gonna try on all the garments that I bought just to see how they all look together, and then I'm gonna jump into starting to cover the corset with the glittery fabric. Okay, don't mind my microphone. It was too hard to try to conceal it in the costume just for this quick little snippet here. But the pieces that I bought for the base actually already look like a pretty decent Elsa costume as it is. So if you really wanted, you could really just buy like this shirt, this corset, and this skirt and like have an Elsa cosplay. And then yeah, this shirt, this sheer top does tend to fall like up here on your shoulders, whereas Elsa's costume, it's a little bit more off the shoulder like that. But I don't think I have to cut it. I think if I just kind of place it there, it just kind of stays put. So I think that's pretty much how Elsa's dress is. So yeah, I think this is an amazing base. I'm getting super excited. So now I'm gonna jump right into sewing and attaching that rhinestone glittery blue fabric to the corset. So the very first thing I did was use a hot glue gun to glue the corset shut in the front. I glued down the entire panels. I also put a lot of glue on each clip to help keep them closed. I also glued down this little flap of fabric just to make sure it lied completely flat when I was wearing it. Then, just for good measure, I went ahead and also sewed the corset shut as well. I kind of did this pretty quickly and messily because I knew I was just going to cover the corset with the blue fabric anyway, so it didn't have to look perfect. Next thing I did was I laid out my corset on top of the blue fabric and cut out a rough shape that kind of fit the size of the fabric. So I just loosely pinned the corset to the fabric before cutting it just to hold everything in place. But I also recommend having someone wear it for you if you can. Have a lovely assistant and you can kind of shape the fabric a little bit more accurately to the shape of the corset so everything lies neat and flat. Just be careful with this sequiny fabric because you're definitely going to make a mess as you're cutting it out. You're going to get sequins everywhere. So of course, sewing the fabric onto the corset, I wanted to minimize the visibility of the thread, so I used a thread that matched the same color as the fabric, which was a great help because it was really hard to even see the thread at all. And then on top of that, instead of just sewing straight across with the thread, I recommend using anchor points instead. So an anchor point is pretty much just looping the thread through the fabric in the same point a couple times over so it holds tight and anchors it in place. I did that all along the top edges and the bottom edges and the sides of the corset, and you can even do it a couple times in the middle of the corset as well to make sure everything lies flat. Once everything is sewed into place, you can start to trim the excess fabric off to neaten up the edges. You want to make sure you still have some fabric hanging over the top and the bottom because you're going to want to secure that on the inside of the corset so it all lies really flat. You can sew these down as you're adding your anchor points if you want with the thread, but I just chose to hot glue my edges down instead. To preserve the baby doll neckline on the front of the corset with the little curve in the front, you can just cut a little slit in the top of the fabric right where the neckline swoops in a little bit. That way you can glue the sides down a little bit more easily. Whereas if you didn't add the slit, it would kind of create a straight line across the baby doll neckline. You could even cut slits around the curve as well, just to help keep it a little bit more smooth going around the curves. Then just go ahead and hot glue all of your edges down. The edges around the back of the corset where it laces up looked a little bit choppy where I cut the fabric, so just to give it a little bit more of a finished look, I just covered up those edges by hot gluing some ribbon on top. Now moving on to gluing the rhinestones onto this sheer top. I mostly wanted to add the rhinestones just along the neckline area and on the sleeves. I used E6000 glue, which is great for crafting projects, and these little rhinestones. I used a nozzle tip on the glue to make it a little bit easier to work with, and these two tools came with the rhinestone kit that I got. These little needle nose tweezers were super helpful, as well as this little pencil that helps you to pick up the rhinestones and put them into place without using your fingers. Be very careful working with this glue. You're not supposed to inhale the fumes, so maybe wear a mask, and definitely avoid getting it on your skin as well. I was not being as careful as I should have, so do not copy what I'm doing here. These rhinestones are great because they come in a couple different sizes, so you can really create a variation rather than just having a boring uniform look. I put the rhinestones all along the edge of the neckline, as well as on any sort of seams, just to kind of cover those up, so where the sleeve attached to the bodice as well. Now for the cape part. To attach the cape to the rest of the dress, I decided to attach it to this ribbon. To create more of a flowy pleated look, you can just fold the fabric over as you're sewing it in place to kind of create a pleat. It's really easy to do. I just pinned it into place on this ribbon in that pleated fold, and then once that was done, I just moved over to my sewing machine to neatly sew it into place, pulling the pins out as I go. I added snap buttons to the ends of each side of the ribbon so that I can just snap it onto the back of my corset, where I also added little tiny ribbons with the opposite button on there so I could just pin it onto the corset. Brings me to the end of how I made my own Elsa costume dress. I love how it came out with the rhinestones on the arm. I think that brought this shirt from like a 5 to like a 10. I love how this shirt looks with the rhinestones, and I would honestly wear it just on its own. I think the corset looks so much more unique and so much more Elsa now that it has the sparkly fabric on it. Of the store-bought costumes that I bought, I think the one that was supposed to look like Elsa's dress in Frozen 1, like the one that I made, I think that one actually came out super, super nice. And if you don't want to put in any effort to making a dress, that one is actually amazing. When I read the reviews for it, I did not think it was going to be nearly as nice. So many people said it was see-through. It really was not at all. I actually really, really liked how that dress looked. As far as the one from Party City that's supposed to be the Frozen 2 dress, I'm not the biggest fan of that. It looks okay, but it just kind of looks like a Halloween store costume, whereas the other one actually looks like a nice dress. It's obviously an Elsa dress, but it's like a nice Elsa dress. Making my own was a lot of fun. I feel weird saying making my own because I don't want people to think that I made like the pieces that it was made out of, like the shirt and the corset and stuff. Like, I didn't make the bases, but it was a lot of fun to customize and make it my own and kind of make it more unique. So ultimately, I do think mine came out better than the store-bought Elsa costume, but that one also is an option if you don't want to put an effort to customizing one. But I do actually really, really love how this costume came out as well. But like I said in the beginning of this video, you're definitely going to spend a fortune on buying all the supplies to make the costume. So if you're actually a better crafter than I am and you want to make the shirt completely from scratch and the corset completely from scratch, you'd probably save a lot of money. But because I wasn't totally confident in making those things and didn't have the right sewing machine and tools to make them, I just went with modifying things that were pre-made, which is totally an option if you're more of a beginner like I am. But if you want to save even more money, then just make it completely from scratch. Let me know in the comments below if you guys want to see more cosplay transformations. I have a bunch more coming that I'm so excited to share with you guys. And thank you so much for watching this video, and I will see you in the next one.